everyone, and welcome back to the Cook to Flourish Kitchen in partnership with Where the Red Fern Grows Farms. And today we get to make a sweet Swiss chard dish that I hope you just love. Now, oftentimes when we use Swiss chard, we make it into savory dishes, but today we're going to change that and we're going to make it sweet. So all you're going to have to do is to get a purple organic sweet potato. Yes, purple. They are beautiful and full of antioxidants. You're also going to need 4 cups of fresh Swiss chard. Now, you're going to want to just use half of that organic purple sweet potato and slice it into about 1/8 to 1/4 inch thick slices. You're going to want to have a pot on the stove that is boiling with water and put a steamer basket into the pot. Now, once that water is to a rapid boil, add in your sliced purple sweet potatoes, put the lid on, and let those get nice and tender. It takes about 5 to 7 minutes for them to get fork tender. Then you're going to take out the sweet potatoes, put them into a bowl, set them aside, keep them warm. You're going to need them here in just a few minutes. Next, you're going to add in the Swiss chard into now that steamer basket. Put the lid on. It's just going to take 2 to 4 minutes, so watch it really carefully. While it's in there nice and getting steamy, you're going to want to take another bowl, a serving bowl, and add 1/2 tablespoon of butter flavored olive oil, and also 1/2 tablespoon of maple balsamic vinegar and 1/4 teaspoon of ground cinnamon. Stir that together in your mixing bowl or in your serving bowl with a little bit of sea salt, a little bit of pepper, and then by that time your Swiss chard should just about be ready. So take the lid off, put the Swiss chard into that mixing bowl or serving bowl, and toss it with the butter and the maple and that cinnamon. It's gonna smell so good. Turn off the heat, of course, from the stove, and then you're going to want to place it and add your sweet potatoes on the side. Put any extra of that dressing onto it, and if you wanted to put any pecans or almonds or walnuts, that would be amazing as well. And then you can just take a fork and you can start to enjoy. So I hope that you really, really enjoy this dish. God bless you, and we will see you later.